Donald Trump, you are an absolute disgrace to America. For those of you who are interested in what I would say to our former president, you might want to speed it up. Hold right here. Mr. Trump, I saw your rally in Georgia today where you said not one word about the good work of the current administration or diplomats in bringing home Americans. In bringing home a Marine. Instead, you congratulated the dictator who was holding them hostage. You congratulated a tyrant who trumped up espionage charges on American citizens. I don't know why I'm surprised, given that you invited Russia to target your opponent when you were running in 2016, given that you never believed any of the 11 intelligence agencies that said that Russia interfered in the 2016 election, given the fact that at every opportunity to defend Americans, you stood with Russia instead. And when Russia helped Iran put bounties onto the heads of American service members, you said nothing. Given the fact that when Russia coordinated with the Taliban to target American service members, you were too much of a coward to stand up for Americans. You are an absolute pathetic man. Every time a patriot, an actual patriot, has stood up to you, you go on personal attacks. Members of the military, national security experts, terrorism experts, members of the intelligence community, you find them useless. In fact, you stood in front of the Star Wall at Langley and bragged about yourself. Those stars are people, people who gave their lives for this nation. And you used the backdrop of that to brag about how wealthy you were. It's no wonder that you only got your Truth Social off the ground by coordinating with relatives of Russian oligarchs on the sanctions list. It's no wonder that you only wanted to talk to Vladimir Putin in Helsinki if there were no witnesses. It's no wonder you repeatedly, at every opportunity, have spit in the faces of Americans to defend Russia. And we all know exactly why now, given that the intelligence community is once again saying that Russia is trying to interfere in our election, we all know why you're praising Putin, because you're afraid he won't back you again. But more than that, when you run away from America because you are running from the consequences of your cowardice and your treason, you want somewhere to go, and you are desperate to have Putin welcome you with open arms. Benedict Arnold is the most famous traitor in American history for being loyal to his king. You don't have that excuse. You don't have the honor either. You have outdone him, Mr. Trump, with your being a Russian asset for decades. You are a spy. You are a rapist. You are a predator of children. You assault women. You are a bigot, a xenophobe, a racist, a fake Christian. You are a traitor to America and to American ideals. It's why you are so willing to, as you put it, terminate all rules and regulations to include the Constitution. And why were you willing to do that? Because you lost. and you could not cheat and steal your way to power. That's why you're so desperate now. You don't want anyone to know just how far you have gone to sell this nation to the highest bidder. As if we didn't know about the payments from Egypt or Saudi Arabia or China or Russia. You are loyal to anyone who will put money in your pocket, and you will sacrifice American patriots if it makes you wealthy. You are disgusting, Mr. Trump. How dare you? You once said that General Milley deserved a very specific fate because he stopped China from thinking we were going to initiate a war, and you were angry that he was able to calm them down. So you threatened his life. The chairman of the Joint Chief of Staff, you threatened him with public execution. And that is exactly why we all know now that you will defect. Because you accuse others, you project everything you're thinking onto others, and you are terrified that when you have to stand in front of the 330 million people in the United States of America, that you will be the one to face a traitor's fate. I wish you a long and happy life, Mr. Trump, behind bars with nothing. May you suffer in your prison cell until your last breath, and then may you be judged by the Creator and enjoy an eternal fate you well deserve.